So can we have the votes into a question first? Please take the remote controls, and we will have it by sponsored by Score Media. So the question will be, do you think it is possible to find a common currency for video content? Number one, no. I don't think the parties will be able to come up with a common solution in the near future. TV and online are too far away right now. Number two, yes, the parties will agree on a currency soon. It will be challenging to find a common solution for the different channels, but in the end, it will be indispensable for the whole video and mobile content industry. This is probably the longest answers I've ever had in the last 2 days. Good. Can you vote now, please, so we get your answers? And I'm going to take a seat here, just between you, so that you're not fighting against each other, but you can fight in words now. So, and I would love to start, obviously, with the traditional industry soon. But first of all, what do you think? What's going to be the answer, Martin?
The answer will be no. But I believe yes.
Okay. Martin.
Martin. Yeah. I hope that it's a yes.
Okay. Yes. Petty?
Well, I know that it will be a yes.
Okay. Marianne?
Clearly yes.
Okay, a clear yes. So let's see what's going to come up. What is the audience thinking? Oh, that's very close, actually. That's very, very close. Okay, so you'll agree on a currency. Would you say yes or no, Martin? No, come on. Now you can explore on that answer. You can be a bit more elaborative. Do you think there will be... What is the main challenges at the moment in the market that you see from a traditional TV perspective to find a currency so that we can measure these two worlds?
To be honest, I don't see the problem within the traditional TV industry at the moment. Why should there be a problem? Because at the moment, it's obviously that the data would support the traditional TV stations. So why should we be against it? There is no reason. In every business, every one of us knows exactly what he wants and why he wants to achieve an objective. Or other alternative, why he is a little bit defensive. So you asked why the classical TV stations, where the problems or the obstacles are. There are not many, and I believe we are quite happy to solve them.
Is that the same kind of viewpoint that you have, Martin, at Sky?
Honestly, it's for me, it's more the question which KPIs we have to use in the future. For example, I had yesterday the discussion with the agency about the last match day of the Bundesliga, because I told him on the Friday match, Schalke versus Bayern Munich, we had 1 million visitors on linear TV and 30% on Sky Go in streaming. And the question was, okay, which KPI you can aggregate? Is the 30% aggregation of Sky Go the same usage like the linear TV in minutes? So they couldn't give him the answer. That's the main question we have, and what we like to understand on our platform, how we can handle KPIs between the linear and the streaming usage. And for me, it's not the question about new players or traditional TV. We have to find or to create the KPIs what we can handle for the future.
Is that kind of, how's the perspective on YouTube? I can imagine YouTube, if you look at kind of the younger generations, obviously they are using, my sons are a disaster. They're more on YouTube, they don't like you anymore, I have to admit. They're more on YouTube than anywhere else, not even on Facebook. So they use it as a search engine more or less, but that's how they perceive it. So, but when I ask them actually how they are using it, they cannot tell me anything around advertising. They can't even see the difference between advertising and normal content. So when we are talking about KPIs, isn't that one of the most critical points, that actually the young generation is not interested actually in seeing any advertising at the moment? Or is it completely different?
Well, you know what, I think kind of like it's a question of if it's relevant or not. Yes, we have a lot of these discussions, and if the advertising is relevant then it's information, and they are absolutely open for it. So, I kind of like, it's a big echo here, guy, clearly. You clearly can't hear me. I can hear myself. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Yeah, very well. Yeah. No, so I think the key thing for a brander really is that if I look at kind of like in my wallet, I have a Visa card, because I was brought up with Visa, with Olympics and so on and so forth, and you cannot get me to become a MasterCard or American Express guy. So you need to absolutely make sure you reach those young audiences right now when you can still influence them. And for that, mobile new platforms are absolutely critical.
So it's I can't remember discussions that we had kind of 2 years ago around Facebook, and everybody was saying basically it's a young generation going there. But it's kind of changing between even you two, right, at the moment. So I can imagine that you are targeting completely different people than Facebook at the moment. Is that true? Is that kind of an experience you have as well, or would you say it's completely different?
Well, look, here's the thing. I think the most important thing to note is that, first of all, TV works for brand advertising, Facebook works for brand advertising, and Google and others as well. The thing is that if you look at advertisers right now, I think it's very important that we concentrate on where value is being created for brand advertisers and brand, and it doesn't matter what kind of target group it is. And where's value created? That's on the consumer level. And consumers, they are people, and people are mobile. And mobile screen time is really huge. With 3 hours a day, it's their first device now, and so their first screen. And so I think if we talk about currency, etc., I think the first thing we need to acknowledge is this change. And from my perspective, and if you think, and we all know that majority of brands are targeting against adults 14 to 49, and if you just think that 20% of their view time is mobile and mobile video, I think the real topic we're talking about is really like really finding the right balance. And you know, I've got a heritage as a media strategist, so I'm very much focused on where value is created, and that's where the people, as we said. And so I think the discussion, the relevant discussion really is really to put people first and really think people have made the shift to mobile, and advertisers, they need to make that thing a change too. And if you just think about the 26% view time on mobile and about 1 to 2% advertising spend that's currently on mobile, I truly believe that the main topic really is that advertisers need to rethink their current media mix. And the younger any target group is, the more relevant it is. I just saw a study where about 1/5 of the 18 to 24 year old target group haven't used any TV in the last 6 months. And I mean, if you just think 1/5 of that group, no TV at all in the last 6 months, I think this is something that should be eye-opening for brand advertisers, and this is something we should be discussing about.
But isn't that saying that actually, yeah. That actually 80% are saying yes, so more or less. So 80% are still on it. So that means it is, so I'm trying to get the point here. The big question is, are we really kind of facing this challenge at the moment, or is it just a target group difference? Younger generations probably more on your end, traditional more on your end.
Now we're coming to the heart of the issue of the debate. We began at the second step. Let's come back to the first step. And we had a perfect example, Marianne, as far as I understood. It's not that easy to understand everything. Sorry for that, because the acoustic is not very
it's
fine.
It's not brilliant, yeah.
It's not brilliant.
It's probably everybody out there here is better than us.
What I understood is really going to the heart of our discussion, because everyone has his own figures. And the figures that you mentioned have nothing, and I say nothing, to do with the figures we have. And that is the issue. Because everyone has figures. Everyone has billions of impressions. But
the issue of the discussion is not, I love to fight against Facebook and YouTube, as you both know, but that's, maybe you come to that later, but the real issue is, why can't we have a common, let's call it currency,
well, KPIs, whatever you want to name it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Call it like, but why can't we have it? Because to answer, or to give you an answer on your figures, 93% of the video viewing time altogether is linear TV. So I don't know where the 20% come from, and that's the issue, that's the problem. And my question is, why are you not taking part in that common effort, in that common research? And please don't say, please not, that we are mobile, we have other devices. That's the same for Martin. And he is part of that joint industry committee. And what he is doing is, in my opinion, the perfect solution. He is part of the AGF. Mm. AGF sounds a little bit... Arbeitsgemeinschaft Fernsehforschung. Yeah. But on the other hand, he is developing the system within the AGF, and he has his own additional studies for the mobile thing. And that is very important for him too.
Martin, you're disappointed me. Normally, you really disappoint me because normally I know that you're really on top of things. And so I think you're well aware that we're in discussions. I think Facebook is known as a company that moves fast. Sometimes the way we're moving fast is challenging for other companies and for institutions as well. And so you know that we're in discussions and that we would love to be part of it. You know that we're discussing a pilot. And so very open and very happy.
Marianne, sorry. Well, that is too easy. Because
at least that was one of the results that we have
just
here. That's good.
One small answer. That has to be. Because the discussion was opened more than 5 years ago. And you say Facebook is fast. And your predecessor said to me the problem with the AGF and the ACMA and the ARGOF and all the other joint industry committees is that they are slow. He said, it's a snail race. And if that is a snail race, then you don't even qualify for the minimum speed.
Given the chance to answer.
First to the numbers, I have to say, it reminded me of my son. He must have been like 6 or 7 years old, and we had a discussion. So what came first, the hen or the egg? And my son's answer was that, well, the hen thinks it's the hen, and the egg thinks it was the egg. And I think kind of like partly with these numbers, it's kind of like you can twist those numbers like you want. The truth is, though, that if we really look at kind of like the results our advertisers get from their campaigns on YouTube, many times on mobile, because like that is really where the big growth is. And that's also where you can really touch those clients and those customers in the moment that they're really open for it. The results are amazing. But that's another thing. What comes to the AGF, I think it takes two to tango here. And it's from both sides. So yes, I agree. We could probably be faster in some things. At the same time, we do really want to find out also solutions that are not only solely for Germany. At the same time, what's great to see is that we're really moving as a first mover in Germany in this space. But we want to take a look at kind of like how can we solve this thing in France, in the UK, in many other countries as well. I think we have a very good collaboration going on right now with AGF. I think a very good also mutual trust in really developing these things. These are not simple. Yeah. If they would be simple, they would have been done already. And so I don't see kind of like what's the point.
Is it a political? The question is it very easy kind of to do it, or is it a political or a technical problem that we are facing here?
I think it's a little bit of a political, because like there are things like, for example, how do you define some of those metrics? For example, view time and so on. But mostly I would say it's a technical question. It's a technical question on how do we connect these things. And we underestimated the complexity probably, but so did also AGF. But again, I can, like, I am really, really feel positive about the development we're doing there, and that's why I don't even like the way we're kind of like right now telling, oh, you are not doing your work, we're not doing our work, we're here in together and developing the market together.
But we mix up the market with different figures.
I beg your pardon?
We mix up the market with different figures since 10 years.
I don't know.
And that is not helpful. Yeah, so
well, you know what? Like, I joined Google 10 years ago, and we acquired YouTube about 10 years ago. So I think 10 years
there 10 years ago.
That's exactly it.
So it's a new world.
But you're kind of a hybrid, because as we've heard before, you have kind of experienced a change. You've done it yourself, you're participating in one group and the other, so you're doing both ends. Now you've got the experience, what is the better way, actually?
Yeah, what's the better way? It's a good question, because we are in the middle of a battle, so Made Sky is in the middle of what's happened in the real world. So I think it's true that the TV is in the middle of a drop, especially for younger target groups, and the usage dropped by, I don't know, 8 to 10% for 14, 48, 29. That's true, yeah? But you have to be care why there's a drop. It's not because the younger target groups don't watch TV anymore. They watch the content as well, but on other platforms. And there is a, for me, the best example is Sky Go. The share of the target group 14-29 of Sky Go is 40%, yes. 40. And we also have a small drop in our ratings in Bundesliga and in movies and series as well on the linear signals. But we have a significant growth on Sky Go on demand platforms. So the question will be how we can measure all these platforms. So we start with our own measurement in the last couple of weeks, and I talked about that last year, and to understand at first about the motivation. One, when a younger target group will use this device or on demand or live on linear, and how we can measure that and how we can handle the KPIs behind that.
But in the end, isn't it in the end that the brands are setting the stage? I mean, the brands set the KPIs. The brands want to see whether it makes sense, they get the right results. So, and what I wonder is, are they going into your direction or are they going into your direction?
Well, money
so
moves
where are
where
they?
The eyeballs are.
Yeah.
It's been always in advertising that way. And clearly, TV is still doing Germany pretty well. Congratulations. Wonderful. At the same time, let me come back to this 93%. So I think this 93% is, we've never seen how you measure that. But it's absolutely wrong. It's a joke. To be honest.
It's
like if I look at. Let me just finish this. I took a little quick view on what's the top viewed TV shows on Sunday. Sylvester Stallone did very well on RTL. They had about 1.5 million viewers between the 14 and 49 year olds in that in their space. I looked at BB. How many of you know BB? Yes, BB is wonderful.
Who knows BB?
Well, most of them do. BB had in a day 1.7 million viewers or views in that space. So it's like, I think it's like, you know what, whatever we have as a currency right now, if the eyeballs move there, that's where the brands move. And we're really happy to have amazing advertisers that can see that.
I have to answer for the 93.
Good.
And then for the eyeballs, first, the 93% is from the view time report done by 7-1 Media. And
you have mobile?
And yes, we have mobile.
Did you do that on phone?
We did do that, but question.
Over telephone?
But let me explain, be relaxed. We proved it via technical software within 1,000 YouTube users. So we proved the results. You can have
you
this
know how
method.
Many, you know the how difference, many YouTube
the difference,
users we have?
The difference between us is and I include 7.1 on our side, that we are transparent. You can see the methods. You can see what they have done. You can read everything. And the results are proved. And they are honestly proved on different ways. What you are doing is more a black box for us.
No, for us,
it's a black box. I've never seen the methods. I've never seen the panel, really, that you use. We had a lot of questions.
You should buy advertising, and you would see all the numbers.
It's just if you want to compare data, try to be transparent. We try to.
I think maybe not every research,
and let's be a little bit friendly from my side.
Thank you.
Maybe not every research is 100% correct, but what we all should do is to be transparent and show what we did, how we did it, and then all our clients and competitors can prove if that is right or not.
But I think that
data are provable.
There's one thing which I wonder. Can we not do a test? So if you do a test, you define a target group, you define a period, you give 20 advertisers the opportunity in that period to advertise here and there, wherever it might be, on Facebook and YouTube, on all planets, let's put it that way, on all TV planets. What would happen? What is the idea? Is that possible? Can you imagine doing that? Because then the numbers would be comparable.
But you define, let's say, three
KPIs. It's a very easy test.
But actually, we're doing this right now.
Exactly.
And I mean, all big brand advertisers, they know that people have gone mobile, and they know that there's a big shift in media consumption. I think there's no doubt about it, and everybody in the room here will agree. I mean, if you just walk in the streets of any particular city, you'll find people on their mobiles, and they use it for all different kinds of purposes and different platforms. So I think this is something we can all agree on, and I think the one thing we all agree on is that that any measurement must reflect that, and whatever changes we are doing to do together in a transparent way will need to reflect that, otherwise we are not going to establish a system that will be valid for the future. So there will be something new. So what's happening in our daily praxis is that advertisers do run their campaigns in a media mix. And depending what their goal is, depending on what their target group is, they come up with different mixes. And I believe that this is totally the right thing to do because, as I said before, it's not an either or. We try to facilitate frontiers. But as a matter of fact, if you want to maximize effectiveness for a brand, for any given brand, you will need to come up with a mix. And the question is not an either or. As I just said before, TV has proven its effectiveness. But Facebook has proven its effectiveness as well. And it's proven its return on investment. If you just think about the Opel case that we just established, Opel had invested 7% of their total media budget. And with that 7%, they increased their ad recall by 82%, and especially their brand favorability by 30%. And those 30% in only 6 weeks. And if you, I mean, everybody of you who's running brands and who's familiar with these kinds of KPIs, they know that really making such a shift in only 6 weeks, I mean, imagine. And so in the real world, advertisers do make these tests. And really, I mean, I've been really working with brand advertisers barely all of my life. And I think we all know, and I think this is something we can agree on. It's not an either or, but it's really the question what the best mix is. And the one thing that I'm saying is that if we target effectiveness for a moment, the one thing that I'd advocate for is just like, if you see where people are in their media consumption, and we can debate the figures and the sources, but I think there's no doubt, even between the two of us, that the view time, however high it is on mobile, is not in a reasonable balance with the ad spend. And the thing is that, especially if you think about mobile video, and if you think of the vast acceleration we've just seen with broadband and the distribution of smartphones and everything, how quickly this development is evolving. I think that every advertiser today needs to test and learn just to be fit for the future in any target group.
What I actually wonder is, Is there a discussion going on the advertiser side? What is better? Because
surely.
Is it?
Surely. 100%. Yeah. And I'm not an advertiser. Martin is an advertiser. Maybe he can add some thing that really, helps.
Then give us the end.
Yeah.
I'm fine. I'm flexible here.
Our advantage, our advantage is that we are a sales house, we are a broadcaster, and we are one of the biggest advertisers in Europe.
Yeah.
So for us, it's easy to understand which media is working well, which not. And if you ask an advertiser, I think every advertiser will give you another answer, because it's depending on the targets the advertisers have. So we increased our digital budgets for Sky. I don't know exactly the numbers, but it's we have a significant growth in our digital spendings. But the main spending is still TV. Why? Why for TV, it's all the branding effects what Sky needs. It's the best what we can measure. For digital, it's digital is massive for us, because there's a contribution for our subscription model. It's excellent, and it's cheaper than other media. So it's for us it's more how the media will works and what target we have. For branding it's TV. For reach it's TV.
But you're going for subscriptions, obviously.
Yeah.
So subscriptions is e-commerce in some way. Yeah. Right? So it's hard facts. We want to have hard numbers. We want to have, and then it makes sense to go via direct, right?
Yeah. For Sky, it's not a question, digital or TV. It's an additional. It's aggregation of both.
I think it's also critical. I think I also agree completely with you. It's really a question of media mix here. And the question is really kind of like, how do you more or less manage your entire sales funnel from the branding side all the way to the conversions? And of course, every brand is different here. They have different targets, they have different KPIs and so on. But I think kind of like the key thing here is really that the development is also extremely fast in the last years, and especially development towards mobile. I can only agree on that, because we see a 90% growth in view time on mobile just in the last year. And it's just kind of like, it's just a huge shift that we see. But also, we do see a lot of also the advertisers really realizing this.
But is that kind
I have
of
one additional remark, because eyeballs are not impact. Mm-hmm. And especially for mobile, eyeballs that you have are not powerful, are not easy
to work with.
You
have a study for this too?
Yeah, surely. Everyone has a study. That's not the problem. You have 100 studies. But the question is not whether you have studies. The question is whether mobile really works that powerful that the eyeballs are transferred into impact and then into money. And that's the order, not the other way around.
Well,
it's not eyeballs and then money. It's eyeballs, impact, and then money. And that is the reason why TV. That is the reason why TV grows. Linear TV.
Can I say something?
Yes. That's it.
Of course, reach is not equal. All reach does not equal all reach. So the question is really what kind of reach you get. And the question really there is that how do you make sure that you get the right creative at the right time in front of the right device? And this is obviously kind of like depends very much on the goals also you have. And if I kind of like going into the supermarket and waiting for my bus there, watching my mobile phone there, this is obviously a very different moment to catch the audience for many of those brands that are in the supermarket that time than maybe if I'm kind of like at home and waiting for Sylvester Stallone to start. But again, this is again a part of the media mix, a part of the creative mix also you need to do. And I think like what's wonderful here is that as an advertiser today, you have so many more choices, making sure where do you catch the people, are they willing in that moment to communicate with you, and is your creative also the right for you, for you, and for you. And this is, I think, kind of like what's also so exciting about this time.
I mean, sorry, Martin.
We launched a study just, I don't know, 4 or 5 weeks ago about the impact of a 30-second spot in TV and pre-roll on Sky Go. where's the differences, and what about the impact for the advertiser on every platform? We could measure that on TV. The impact is a little bit better than SkyGo. It's better, but not so much. But what we also learned that on, especially on the mobile devices, the reactance is much bigger on than on TV. So on mobile, you have to be very, very careful how often you will send out the ad to the viewer. And otherwise, you will have a big, big problem with the reactance.
But isn't that the general problem? I mean, on mobiles, to be fairly honest, I mean, most of the advertisers would love to be. But the truth is, the user hates it. I mean, I hate when I get a pre-roll. I hate when I get disturbed in watching a video. It's, to be fair, I just want to watch. If I could pay, to be perfectly honest, I would pay for YouTube. I wouldn't even think about it. I years ago said
I have a subscription model for YouTube.
Oh, yeah. I'm already a subscriber of yours anyway, so forget it. isn't that, we are talking about something where actually there's difference, I think, between the advertisers and the consumers. The advertisers want to be where the eyeballs are, obviously, and they want to make as much money out of it. But the users are completely different. Users are changing, and we have a massive evolution at the moment.
Yes.
We have complete new shows. We have Netflix and Amazon completely turning around the world and taking people, sorry to say that, off your worlds. I see my kids, to be fairly honest. I see all their friends. They are not in your worlds anymore. Absolutely not in your worlds. They are on YouTube. Some on Facebook, maybe.
Let me add on that. I think I'm completely with you, and I think like one of the, I think one of the most, search being a product where people more or less would say, I'm interested now in a new car, tell me something about it. We have a similar product in YouTube called TrueView, and I think TrueView is kind of like the great thing about TrueView is that we'll ask you if you're interested to watch this.
Yeah.
Because there are times when I'm interested to watch car ads, for example. I'm probably not interested in watching car ads right when I bought one.
Yeah.
But it could be that, you know, it's like I'm about to buy.
But I would like
exactly.
to.
But I have the choice to choose if I want to see an ad.
Yeah.
I mean, what you said is totally true. And it's totally true since I joined the industry, which is in the late 80s. So the question on whether people are open to advertising or not, or if they're annoyed by advertising, is as old as advertising, I believe. And so it's no news that the key is relevance. And to create relevance is very tough, especially nowadays, because as you said, so many messages out there, so much crappy advertising out there. And then especially with the digital transformation and people going mobile and having videos all over the place, I think it's especially important that advertisers don't only rethink the media mix, but especially that we all learn how to build creatives in the digital world. Because if you just think, I think the typical storytelling that we all grew up with, I think it goes back to the Greek tragedies. So everything is just designed for the climax. And that works well in cinemas, works well in TV. But in digital, where people don't consume so long, it's more just like a snack size of thing. We all need to learn how to create compelling advertising and content, by the way, that catches your attention immediately. At Facebook, we say it needs to create a thumb-stopping power. So your ad needs to be relevant in the first 2 seconds, because if it's relevant, people may stick to it, and then you need to deliver your message in the next 10 seconds. And then if you're lucky, if it's relevant, they may stay even longer. And my thesis is that as a whole industry, we're going to solve that problem for digital. I'm quite sure communication is going to get better in any channel. And so I think this is one of the challenges that comes with the change and something that's going to be very interesting. And I'm very much looking forward to great creatives on all the media.
Mm. Is that
the
something?
Creatives, the creatives cannot heal everything. I agree 100% with you, Marianne.
I mean, you know that
you
creative
analyze,
is 50% of the
you
success,
analyze
right?
The issue 100% right. There is one more thing, and that is that limits your ability for brands, because relevance is mostly not given for the most consumers. the consumers don't wait to get into interaction with, I don't call a brand, because I love all the brands, but you know what I mean. They are not open for interactive discussion about how to eat apple juice or drink apple juice. That limits, and I don't say it's bad, but it limits the possibilities that you have for many brands. And you mentioned your children. You love them and you educated them very well, but they are a little bit special, because with TV you still...
I hope they are special.
Yeah, I hope so too. So congratulations, congratulations. But you reach with TV 80% of the millennials every week, and they watch more than 2 hours an average. So you cannot say we don't reach the younger target groups. There is a development that Martin described,
that's millennials,
but it's without competition in that target group is still linear TV.
It is in some way. I have to admit. So, yes, I would say probably there's different worlds in which we are at the moment. It is different worlds still, but obviously, if I was a brand advertiser, I would be very much relaxed. I wouldn't even start this discussion.
Exactly.
Because what I would do, actually, I would say, young world, old world, let's see what happens. Piloting here, piloting there, and then see what's going to happen. And what is most important, and that's what I find so interesting, is, I mean, we all want to, every one of you can measure what comes out of it in the end. Whether it's, forget viewability, go into hardcore KPIs. Go into KPIs like, what can I actually buy? What can I purchase? Can I have a subscription model behind it? Yes. How many subscriptions do I get? Fuck it. To be fairly honest,
yeah.
It could be so
exactly.
easy to do
exactly.
that test. Yeah. And I would love to see, to be fairly honest, in a half year's time, seeing you at the Mexico Night Talk, the four of you, and then we are talking about this discussion again, once you've done the pilot and we have the results, and then we can see who is actually in the right corner. So would you appreciate that?
Yeah, 100%. Cool. I would go one step further. I would appreciate if clients put 100% in YouTube and Facebook as a test.
Already get that.
I think these tests that you're referring to, they're happening in real time, as I just said. And many, many brand advertisers are experimenting. And I think, as I said before, this is exactly the right thing, because you need to learn and you won't get it 100% from the beginning. And but there's a real life test going on at the same time, which are called the Effies. And I've been lucky enough to be judging lots of cases, and so I saw many of those cases. And many, many of these cases are really just like combining both worlds, just like Martin just said for Sky, really just like striving for the right mix. And this is exactly the right thing to do. And so what you just said is happening right now. It is not really just about him or Petri or myself. It's the advertisers who do this. And those advertisers, they're measuring the brand effectiveness either with their own sales systems. They've got great independent technical partners for reporting all the KPIs related to performance. And they're using the trusted partners like Millward Brown, like GfK, et cetera, to measure the results. And I know that it's more entertaining if it's controversial. And Martin is always good for having a great controversial debate. But in all essence, I think it's not a controversial debate, because there is no question that TV works, and there is no question that Google works, and there is no question that Facebook works. It's all the question about the right balance of them. And if you go back to the KPIs that you were just mentioned, I think there's no doubt that if it comes to performance, digital is doing great. At least I never heard anybody doubting this kind of thing. And I think if it comes to brand advertising, I mean, apparently we are in the beginning. And for us, I'm just talking for Facebook here, but quite sure our friends from Google will share the same view. For us, it's ultimately important that brand advertisers, they do have a lot of success with Facebook. We want them to be successful. We want them to have more brand impact, whatever the particular KPIs might be. And this is why we're really just like very open and testing these kind of approaches. And the benefit of that is really just like that we are educating the whole industry by publishing more and more of these results. And if you just saw, just recently, we were able to publish a lot of cases. I was mentioning Opel, and there are more cases out there, and they're all public. And so I think there are many, many encouraging results. And even though we are still early stages, I think all of these results show in the same direction, and this is what I just said, that Facebook works, that it's great in a mix. And I think the results should be encouraging enough for all of you, brand advertisers, media agencies, creative agencies, and other partners, to focus more on really putting people first and focus on impact, if I just may finish, and increase and maximize impact instead of increasing TV discounts, which had been the thing over the last time, and it's not healthy. It's not getting anybody anywhere because you're not spending money to increase discount in any medium, but you're spending money because you want to sell something, because you want to build brand equity. And I think this is the important thing.
Yeah.
And that's the real debate.
It was a bit of the Facebook advertising show at the moment. Sorry to say that, but no, time is almost up. No, what I want to say, you had a panel where you're actually testing out a lot of things. And I was wondering if you can create a panel across all parties, let's say 50,000 users, various kind of target groups, and then kind of figure out how are they actually behaving, what are they actually doing. So for a time period, could be another approach.
I mean, he and we could partner because we're having real people data, so we have the single sign login, so would be the same kind of quality and very
you,
much
you
of a mobile story.
As well. He can login as well.
We have
so,
wonderful intention.
Yeah. You can do that
signals
as well.
It's not, that interesting for us, to be honest.
Yeah?
Because you need reach and impact. That's the crucial thing. That can on the top of the cake, you can have the cream, and on top of the cream, you can have the cherry. But the baseline is reach and impact, and that is proven.
And
coming back to the beginning, take part.
We were just talking about the panel. We were just talking about how we can improve the panel and really have real people data
but
and real accuracy.
Let's come back to the
ladies
the
and gentlemen,
real
you
thing
can see
is impact.
We've got a tough group
else.
Here to align these four. I would probably go with you at the back, so you're not kind of
no,
fighting. Yeah?
All easy, all easy.
But it was a pleasure having you here. Thank you very much for your input. I think they've done a really great job here. Thank you very much.